So what you have here is a simple data transfer switch that uses the parallel port. It's quite an old machine, but what I'm going to do with it today is transform it into an amplifier switch. I have this amp here, and so what I'm going to do is use this as the output, something like this. I have these RCA switches I got from somewhere. This is the output I'm going to use for the amplifier, and I'll use this for the inputs. So I have many of them. It's going to be such a project. This is how it looks like inside. Actually, it's an analog switch, which I'm going to verify using my multimeter. The sound means there's a short circuit. So I'm going to place it at A. And so this is A port. I'm going to measure the first port. You see there's a short. I'm going to place it at B. This is B. So there's no connection at A. So I only need it for sound, but since it has the yellow video port, I'm going to use 6 cables. So I'm going to dismantle everything and leave only 6 cables. Saved most of the cables, and now I have like five connectors left with 6 cables each, so a total of 30 cables. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to solder them to these connectors one by one, and then after that I fix them inside this packaging. So let's start. Since the blue one was the output, I'm going to connect it to the black one, one cable at a time, starting with the ground cables. So I finished soldering the units. Not that much of a mess. So what is left is to just arrange it in here. So I can only know this is the output. I can't remember which one of these others go, because as you can see, I have an A, B, C, and D, and also the inputs A, B, C, and D. So I don't know which one goes where. I need to check my tape up here and do the right thing.
So the amp signature is complete, and this is how it looks like. Just to take you a little bit, this is my output. These are my output connectors, and they connect to these four input terminals of my amplifier. On my amplifier, I've connected one speaker and one subwoofer. As an input, this input is connected to my DVD player here, and these two cables are sort of connected to the same input to my laptop here. As of now, the laptop is connected here to A and C. B is connected to the DVD player, and the output is connected straight to the amplifier. As of now, I've tuned it to D, so there's no sound. If I take it back like this, you can see. So right now it's at D. When I switch it like this, so that was the laptop playing. When I take it to B, the DVD will start playing.
You're just in time, man.
So that's the DVD playing.
How I perform color.
Okay. Laptop again. So as you can see, it works fine.